Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Billy Bravo Road to the Show series here in MLB 15 The Show on the PS4. Now, Billy Bravo enters his second season in the majors and second season overall as he was fast-tracked here into the major leagues. This is spring training schedule you're looking at right here, but we're going to go ahead and skip that because we don't need to see what goes on in spring training here. That's come to an end as we've fast-forwarded, and now we're looking at starting off the second season. He's solidified his spot in the rotation, and he'll be pitching one of these games in the Mets series, maybe? Nope, he'll be pitching the fourth game of the year here in Boston against Justin Masterson. So it will be to Fenway Park for Billy Bravo's 2016 debut. Wanted to give you a quick look at what the Baltimore lineup looks like on any given day here in 2016. That's what they're rolling with. Okay, spotlight on Billy Bravo.
Welcome back. I'm Matt Vasgersian here on the MLB pregame show. As we draw closer to the first pitch in this series opener, let's have a look at our Topps player spotlight. Billy Bravo will be our man to watch as he comes off an offseason where he had his contract renewed by the organization because he didn't have enough big league service time to become arbitration eligible.
Yeah, and unless you're signed to a long-term deal early in your career, you're going to find yourself at the mercy of your club your first few seasons. You know, while most teams try to provide fair compensation, it's always a balancing act between keeping the team payroll down and making sure the players aren't feeling taken advantage of. It's not clear what the situation is in this case, but I can tell you, if the player feels he's worth more, he just needs to go out and prove it on the field.
Okay, we're looking forward to this one. Lineups and first pitch on the show coming up next.
That is right. Billy Bravo refused to sign in the offseason what the Orioles pushed his way, and he has no leverage, really. He gets re-signed at whatever they want to sign him at, basically, because he has no room to maneuver there. Look at Baltimore coming out and getting a two spot. No, they're not done. Putting up three in the first inning. Now, if you watch the last season here, you know that's very unlike Baltimore. That's a very un-Baltimore Oriole thing to do right there. Stake Billy Bravo with a 3-0 lead before he even gets to the mound. Facing Mookie Betts, going to hop off the mound, make a quick throw there, and get the leadoff hitter for Boston. You see the Red Sox coming in at 0-3 with a little pressure to win a baseball game here. They don't want to start off on the wrong foot, but that's exactly what they've done. Mookie Betts breaking his bat there and being thrown out. So the next batter is going to ground out to first base. I believe that was Brock Holt. And there are two down. Okay, so far so good for Billy Bravo, but he's worked a long count to Dustin Pedroia, and he loses him with the base hit up the middle. So worked and worked to try to get Pedroia out. It did not work out, and the inning is extended. So we go now to the cleanup hitter. That's Hanley Ramirez. No David Ortiz in the lineup. He retired after last season. That is a wild pitch by Billy Bravo. And all of a sudden, he's put a runner in scoring position with two outs now. Let's see if he can recover against Hanley. 1-0 pitch, and it is ripped center field, and it will be tracked down there before it gets to the monster. Inning is over, and the Orioles maintain that 3-0 lead. All right, let's go see if they score some more runs for Billy Bravo. They do not. So we go to the bottom of the second with that 3-0 score. Kung Fu Panda, Pablo Sandoval, is going to single to right field. Again, worked a long count, fouled off a lot of pitches. Made Bravo work there. He's at 23 pitches already here. And this is Alan Craig with a base hit down the first baseline. Sandoval really got fooled right there. He had to scramble to get to second base even when he really probably should have been on third had he tracked that ball properly. So runners at first and second, nobody out. And this is going to be a strikeout. Needed it right there, and he dug down and got it. So he gets the first out of the inning. Let's see if he can continue this 1-2 count, and strike three right there. Oh, great play by the catcher to get that one in the dirt and hang on. Let's watch again. Second straight strikeout as he's trying to strand these runners. Great play by the catcher right there. Yep, Nice communication between pitcher and catcher, knowing what was coming. So can he get out of the inning here now? That's going to be lined to second base, one hop, the throw, and he's out of there. So despite putting runners on first and second with nobody out, he gets out of the inning unscathed. Nice job right there to recover by Billy Bravo. Let's go now to the bottom of the third inning. Still 3-0. 0-1 count. Mookie bats up. He's going to lay down the bunt. And got a little confused there because my meter didn't come up right away to throw. I thought the third baseman had made the play, but either way, don't think a throw was going to get him there. So base hit on the bunt. And here is Brock Holt with a base hit to right field. Oh, bobbled there out in right field. No Ichiro out there either because he retired. Runner is going to move up an extra base to third. So we got first and third with nobody out. And the Red Sox liking their chances to get back in this game in this inning. Let's see what happens here. 0-1 to Pedroia. He puts the ball in the air to center field. Looks like this will be a sacrifice fly. It's going to be caught for the first out, and the runner does indeed come home to score. So it's 3-1 now as the Red Sox put up their first run of the game. And Pedroia gets the RBI. Now the whole point here, though, is minimizing the inning if you're Billy Bravo. 0-2 count with one out. And he strikes out Hanley Ramirez with the high fastball. Set him up with low pitches. And then comes back with the high heat for his strikeout pitch. Let's watch the replay right here. Hanley just not ready to handle that. Strike three swinging. All right, you've got two outs now. And the runner on first base. This is Sandoval. He'll put the ball in play up the middle. Nice little glove flip there to get the out at second base. And the inning is over. Bravo again. Out of an inning here. Gives up a run, but has the 3-1 lead. It was nice of the Orioles to get those three first-inning runs, but they haven't gotten anything since. Alan Craig's going to pop this one up. Foul territory. Looks like there's plenty of room there to make the catch. Drifts a little bit more towards the dugout there, but he does make the catch for out number one in the fourth. 2-1 count now to the next batter, and this is going to be a fly ball to left field. Should not be a problem, and that will be out number two. All right, Bravo would like to get through an inning here without having any base runners on and have to really bear down. 2-2 pitch with two outs. He's thrown 60 pitches so far. This is going to be a pop-up on the other side of the diamond, third base side, also by the dugout. That one's caught for out number three. So Bravo likes that inning. Doesn't even allow anyone on base, and it's still 3-1. Will the Orioles score another run for him? Nope. Same 3-1 score when it comes to the bottom of the fifth, and that's hit to right field. And will be caught routinely out there. Sets another one down in a row here, which is very nice, giving him the first out of the inning. 2-1 count now, and Mookie bats. He's back. He had the bunt single, and now he's hitting this one in the gap, left center field. Play this in, but he's too quick. He's going to be in there with a double, so Mookie Betts getting things started for a Red Sox rally. That brings Brock Holt to the plate, and he is going to put the 2-2 pitch in play. Knocked down by the second baseman, but he has no play. Infield single, and runners at first and third. The Red Sox have been here before. Will they bring home a run? Pedroia, he's grounded into one. The hop is handled, two. It's a double play. Nice pick at first base there. That throw was spiked a bit. But what a big double play ball when they needed it. Come on out for the next inning here, and you got a ground out. And that is out number one. Hanley Ramirez has grounded out. Let's go to Sandoval's at bat. And he's going to get a hit. No! Taken away by J.J. Hardy. A little bit of a leap there timed, and he makes the catch. So two outs now. 2-1 count. Alan Craig puts it in play to right field. Hold up. This has got some carry. And it is gone into the bullpens. When he hit it at first, I didn't think it was going to get out of here, but it does. Cuts the lead to 3-2 now for the Orioles. Home run Alan Craig, and gives something for the Fenway faithful to get excited about. Let's watch the replay here. Alan Craig, again, gets decent wood on the ball. Hit at the opposite field, and it just kind of looked like a routine fly ball off the bat, but this thing carries and carries well, 394 feet and gone into the Red Sox bullpen. So now it's 3-2, still with two outs, an 0-1 count, and that's line base hit, and it's into the gap in right center field. That's going to be extra bases, double now, following up the home run, and all of a sudden Billy Bravo in a little bit of trouble, seeing that margin of error disappear here, working to the next batter, and the pitch is put in play. It's a base hit to left. Shortstop can't get it. Runner's going to try to score. The relay. He's out at the plate. Oh, a little aggressive there trying to tie up the game, but hey, if they don't handle the relay right, you tie it up, and, well, that wasn't the case. The Orioles do get the out. Bravo, lucky to escape that inning there, still with the lead. He goes to the seventh now. This is put in play out to right field. Should be caught, and it is. One down in the seventh. Where's the pitch count at? We'll have to check in on that in just a second here to see where Bravo is dealing. Yeah, 93 pitches. This may be his last inning. This is Mookie Betts. Strike three. There's that newfound slider that he came up with late in the season last year. His new pitch to his arsenal, his fourth pitch, and it's a strikeout pitch there. With two outs, it's Brock Holt, and he's going to come up with a single to left field. The Red Sox getting hits. They're just not getting those runs home tonight. Not enough to overtake the Orioles at this point. That's going to be it. Buck Showalter comes out of the dugout and asks for the ball from his starter, Billy Bravo. So the first effort here, a quality start, and he leads the game here as he leaves the mound 3-2. He is responsible for the runner at third base, so it could be a no decision if they blow that. But guess what? They hang on to it. They actually tack a couple more on, make it a little easier to breathe for Billy Bravo from that dugout. He picks up his first win, goes 1-0 on the season as they beat the Red Sox 5-2. Now, the Red Sox are now 0-4 after dropping that game. You see a quality start and a win. Bravo will take it because wins were hard to come by with the run support last season. So, unfortunately, they go on a bit of a losing streak here. They haven't won a game since Billy Bravo won, so his next start will be against Miami. The Marlins will be the opponent. Come on back for more Billy Bravo. Hopefully, it'll be a great 2016 campaign. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!